Hey there, it's Billy from OSWTV. This is the OSWTV podcast, as you can hear. What you're going to hear, though, isn't me. It's going to be Kevin Morrison, my partner in crime here on the podcast. He'll be interviewing W3L's Kevin Williams. So you're going to hear a little bit of music, and we're going to go right into it. So thank you for listening, and subscribe. Go onto the Facebook page, go onto oswtv.wordpress.com. Let me hear from you. I want to hear everything. So thank you for listening.
Here in Bishop Mill Hall with Kevin Williams, just after the end of the W3L Northern Tour. Kevin, it's good to see you again, man. How's chicks?
I'm so tired. I'm going to apologise right now. I'm so tired. So the questions I'm about to get asked are going to be the answers of a very, very tired 8-bit superstar.
Not a problem at all. It's been a long tour, four venues, but yeah. It's been a good tour. Today the album's fantastic. So first of all, Kevin Williams, your former gimmick was the Gear of War. What made you change from the Gear of War to the new sort of incarnation of Gamer Club, Kevin Williams?
Just a mixture of things, really. I'd been floating around here and there for a while, and I never really had the sense of what I was meant to be doing in wrestling. That's funny. Been handed a McDonald's cup, but yeah. So I really had to. While I was injured, I really had to think about what I actually wanted to do, because I had the realization of that I've been doing this for a while, and if I didn't change anything or fix anything, then you know there was really no point in me actually continuing. So when I was in a position where I could come back, I had to be something that I actually wanted to do as me, as myself, and as the best kind of wrestling characters, as everyone knows, is their own personality turned up to 10, and that's what I think that what I'm doing now, all the kind of gamer-related stuff and all that, all the fun that ensues. I mean, you've seen that pretty much refined today. That's exactly what I'm going to be doing, pushing forward.
Yeah, certainly the fantastic outfit you've got, the sort of Mario Kart trunks. Not Mario Kart, sorry, just Super Mario Bros. Trunks is fantastic. Now, you mentioned there you're out for a little while with an injury. Can you tell us exactly how long you're out for? And also, given obviously being sort of semi-professional wrestler, it's not your main way of life.
Yeah.
How long were you out for, and how difficult was it for you to come back from that?
I was out between actual matches for probably a year and 3 months. I could be wrong about that. I had injured my knee shortly before leaving for a match, and I had to kind of just tough my way through that, because it was all kind of arranged and all that kind of stuff, and I just took time off from then, because I knew myself that I was, you know, immensely out of shape, overweight, all that kind of stuff, and it was affecting my day-to-day health, not just trying to get in there and do wrestling. So it took me about a year after I returned from holiday. I was 18 stone 11. And then that was the kicker. Actually, when I was on holiday, it was a case of we were in Universal Studios, and we went to the Hulk roller coaster, and I had to sit in the big guy seats. And that was the penny dropping off. You need to change. So yeah, over the past, from then, from that November, since I came back to right now, I'm sitting at 4.5 stone loss, and it's made a complete difference.
That's fantastic.
It's probably only been like three or 4 months since I've been back in the ring, but it probably took me about 6 months to get just back into training and slowly losing the weight and working out and all that kind of stuff. And I do CrossFit as well.
Yeah.
Kind of Seth Rollins protege when it comes to that kind of stuff. I'm fully on board with the CrossFit train.
Fantastic, it's a good way to go, isn't it?
Yeah.
So in terms of like your own future, and right now obviously you're in W3L, what's your personal ambitions, and then after that the ambitions for W3L as a company in the future?
Just to kind of dad away at W3L, and there's all kinds of kind of people that are involved with W3L that have their own little projects, and what what I kind of hope is people kind of think of me when someone comes up with a new wrestlers for a card, if they kind of realise that, you know, Kev has been working hard over the past year and a bit, and Kev has gotten himself to a level where he's usable, and you know, he's a good hand. Like anything I do, I put 110% into it now.
Yeah.
And hopefully, just, you know, regular working. And W3L was great. Like, I've never been this busy ever.
That's fantastic.
So it's fantastic. Yeah. So just adding on, and just more bookings for the A-Bit superstar.
That's really good to hear. So going back to your injury, is there any superstars from the sort of the WWE or TNA or things like that that you use as an inspiration to get you through your time of injury?
I wouldn't say so. Like, I know that the kind of big example would be Triple H. Like I've been injured in matches and had to carry on. I've not gone to the lengths that he did. He's torn quad torn off and quad torn off, and then higher in the match. I remember a match where I injured my knee on my entrance, and Young Luke had to take all the heat for a tag team match, and
yeah
that should have been my warning. And from then, I kind of creeped up on myself that I needed to do something about it. I couldn't keep going the way I was. But yeah, like when it comes to like when you see them rehabbing and stuff like that, it really kind of, I would say it's quite similar to what I've actually done. I've realised the problem. I've done things to fix it. And
yeah.
So yeah, like there's probably a bit of truth in that. You do kind of draw inspiration from what you've seen for the other guys for their injuries.
I certainly remember the Triple H injury back in 2001. Yeah. It's horrible. I mean, but obviously yourself going through that tag match with injury, that's pretty hard going.
Because
at least Triple H only had to sort of go on for 5 minutes. You went the entire match. So.
Yeah, I didn't do much. I just got beat up and took what bumps I could.
Oh, still pretty impressive, you know. I mean, but moving on from that. All-time favourite opponent?
All-time favourite opponent? A mix of them. Right now, it would be you and Matthew, because we've been working together for like 3 or 4 days this weekend.
Yeah.
It's been quite good. We've been joined by Mike Rousseau, and he's tons of money. just now, I would see anyone that I'm in the room with as a kind of challenge sort of thing. So I'm kind of building a new repertoire of the people that I like to work with.
Yeah.
So I don't really have an answer to that just now, but
that's okay.
Hopefully I will do.
That's fine, yeah. Any dream opponents, anyone in the world, any promotion, dream opponent?
Oh, Jericho. Hands down. Yeah. Could happen. I know that he's doing like staggered dates for WWE, and like I don't think he'll ever do indies, but you know.
Yeah,
one can hope.
What does that mean? I actually met Jericho back in March. The first three words was "I love you."
Yeah.
So if anyone can make a worse impression than that, I challenge you to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So going back to what we discussed earlier, your new Gamer Club. Can you just obviously it's your new character, and it's like 110% of yourself, as a lot of wrestling characters are.
Yeah.
But can you just like sort of give us a bit more into what Gamer Club is, because obviously there's a Facebook page and the t-shirts you're doing as well.
Yeah, Gamer Club's kind of, it's ripping off Bullet Club.
Yeah.
I blatantly admit that. But it's kind of like, outside of wrestling, I like making like game videos and YouTube videos and all that kind of stuff. And the Gamer Club is a collection of people that I know that do the same thing.
Yeah.
So that's basically it, but then obviously it's to do with wrestling as well, so that's why I wanted to kind of brand that and make it into what it is just now. So anyone listening that really likes listening to this voice talk about video games while playing video games, then you can jump on Gamer Club, and I'll be on my Facebook page. I'm sure there'll be links to that you can check that out for yourselves.
Fantastic. I mean, I know I chat myself, watch some of the videos in Gamer Club. There's a few cracking ones there.
Yeah.
Right, we'll just tie things up now. A lot about word association.
Yeah. Okay.
Just a few sort of acronyms and a couple of things there into the Gamer Club again. So, W3L.
Underrated.
SWA.
Busy.
ICW.
Huge.
WWE.
Boring.
NXT.
Not boring.
Destiny.
Gave up on that game before it got out of the disc, before it got out of the case.
Wow. Gears of War.
I need to own an Xbox One.
Yes, you do. Gamer Club.
Subscribe.
W3L Championship.
Achievement unlocked, hopefully.
And last but not least, OSWTV.
OSWTV. Underrated. Get it watched.
All right, guys. This has been myself, Kevin Morrison, a.k.a. Momo, and this has been Kevin Williams from WCL. Kev, thank you very much.
Game on, folks.
Much
game
appreciated. On. And we'll speak to you soon.